channel. It's me, Jenisha Stanley, again, and today I'm going to review the book, Who is Jane Goodall? This book was written by Roberta Edwards and illustrated by John O'Brien. This book has 106 pages in 8 chapters, including the timeline of Jane Goodall's life and the world. Well, who is Jane Goodall? Well, Jane Goodall is a primatologist. Well, what is a primatologist? Well, a primatologist is a scientist that studies apes like chimpanzees. Jane Goodall was born on April 3rd, 1934 in London, England. And I'm gonna tell you this, when she was a little more than a year old, her father bought her an animal toy. It's not a puppy, kitty, or a soft little rabbit, but a big chimpanzee. Jubilee was the name of Jane's toy chimp, and Jane is still alive today. She is 86 years old, and guess what? She has that small chimp on a dresser in her house. When Jane was 22, she received an invitation from one of her old friends named Chloe. Chloe's family bought a farm in Kenya, Africa. She wanted Jane to come and visit. Did Jane think twice? Of course not. She wanted to go. She stayed at Chloe's farm for a few weeks, and then she wanted to stay here for a few more years, and then she had to look for a job so she wouldn't have to stay at Chloe's farm forever. And then she took a job with a famous scientist named Louis Leakey. He is a paleontologist, and he was looking for fossils, not dinosaur fossils, but fossils of some of the earliest known humans. Once he was looking, and he dug up some artifacts of one of the earliest known humans called Homo habilis. Well, what is that? What is Homo habilis? They were the first kinds of human species to eat meat, and this is what they looked like. And they kind of looked like apes, as you can see here. But the difference is, they walked on two legs. They were hairy, short, and had very long arms. Jane had a lot of interest on chimpanzees, so she wanted to learn more about them. So she wore tan clothes and slipped by some chimps without them even noticing her. She carried a box full of things she needed with her. And then once she got into the right place, she used her binoculars to look at the chimps. Sometimes she saw some males. Sometimes she saw a female caring for her baby. Sometimes she saw males, females, and young all together. And I'm gonna tell you this, chimps are kind of like humans is because mother chimps always give a lot of attention to their young, and they always hug, they can kiss, and also they bow to show respect, and they also get mad. And whenever they do that, they fight. Most people thought that chimps are herbivores and only ate plants. But then, one day, Jane spied on some chimps and she saw that they were eating something while sitting up in a tree. And Jane saw that that something was actually a dead piglet. So they fed on it for 3 hours. And there's one chimp that actually fed the other chimps some food. And they actually ate it and ate it until every last bit of it was gone. So then Jane was the very first person to figure out that chimps were actually omnivores. And like us humans, is because humans eat meat and plants. Jane has been studying chimps for more than 6 decades. In 1977, she established the Jane Goodall Institute in Virginia, United States. And what do everyone in the Jane Goodall Institute do? Well, they study apes like chimpanzees. And at last year in 2019, she was named one of the 100 most influential people on the planet. I'm going to tell you a weird, interesting fact. Did you know that chimps don't sleep on the floor, but they make nests in the trees to sleep in? Well, how do they make them? Well, they bend tree branches together to make a nest, and then they never use that nest again. They need a new nest every day. So after using that nest, they never use it again and go to another tree to make one. From her childhood, Jane loved nature and chimps and kept on following her dream, and then she achieved her goal. So all of you children, if you have a dream, just follow it, your dream, and then one day you may achieve your goal. Everyone, go and read this book to learn more about the real Jane Goodall. And Jane Goodall is still alive today, and she lives in Tanzania. So if any of you go to Tanzania, don't forget to visit Jane. Hey everyone, thanks for watching my videos. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe to my channel to stay tuned in on my new videos. I'll fly over to my next video. See you there!